This video describes a template for designing the clasp-retained Kennedy Class I removable partial denture. The Kennedy system of classification uses Applegate's rules to describe four types of arch forms. Another useful way to think about it is to describe the partial denture as either all tooth supported or tooth tissue supported. The tooth tissue supported partial denture will have an axis of rotation which runs to the most posterior rest on each side of the arch. This requires special consideration in the selection of partial denture components. The cast is surveyed to determine the path of insertion, to locate proximal tooth surfaces that are or can be made parallel, to identify areas of potential retention, to identify areas that will interfere with seating, and to identify areas which may impact the aesthetics of the partial denture. Guiding planes are parallel proximal surfaces which establish a reproducible path of insertion. They are most conveniently placed on the tooth surface adjacent to the edentulous area. Guiding planes for the Kennedy Class I partial denture are short, or about one-third of the occlusal gingival length of the tooth. Rest placement establishes the axis of anterior-posterior rotation, also known as the fulcrum line. Placement of the rest on the mesial of the tooth allows the use of bar clasps with less trauma to the abutment when the partial is in function. When the distal rest is used, wrought wire is the retainer of choice. A cast clasp should not be used, particularly with premolar abutments. This design requires the use of secondary abutments, which act as indirect retainers and serve to orient the framework for relining procedures. A reline is needed if the indirect retainer rotates out of the rest seat with occlusal loading. In an anterior tooth with a well-defined cingulum, a chevron-shaped rest seat may be used. Ledge rest seats may also be used. These rest seats may use composite restorations for support when the enamel is thin or in teeth that are sensitive. The base of choice is usually acrylic to facilitate relining and corrected cast procedures. Metal bases may be used in rare instances. The denture base retainer most commonly used is the latter. Sufficient space for acrylic should be available under the latter. Tissue stops are used as terminal metal stops. These help in stabilizing the framework during try-in and processing. Occasionally, tissue stops may be fabricated with cold cure acrylic if they do not contact the stone cast. In the mandible, the two most common major connectors are the lingual bar and the lingual plate. The plate may be interrupted for aesthetics. In the maxillary arch, the major connector has the palate for additional support. Generally, the poorer the support from the teeth, the greater the area of palatal coverage employed. The framework should be constructed to cover the tuberosity. The major connector may demonstrate a U-shaped form and is always terminated anterior to the vibrating line. In general, two retainers are used, and retention is bilaterally opposed. A few clasps are shown. Reciprocation is required on the primary abutment. It may take the form of a rigid circumferential clasp, a bar vertical minor connector, or plating. If using the mesial rest I-bar and proximal plate, RPI, it is recommended to obtain reciprocation from the mesial bar minor connector and the short distal proximal plate. Test yourself with the following questions, and thank you.